Theos in Logos means the word is exactly expressive of God. If you like, God himself, not somebody else, almost as though John is anticipating the chaos of later years. In the beginning was the word, no capital, the word, the plan, the gospel, God's immortality plan to create immortals to live with him forever. That was in the beginning, parallel to Genesis. And the word was with God. It was in his mind. To have something with you means it's your project. You'll find examples of that. To have something with you, it's like it's my baby. It's my concern. God's concern, the thing he delighted in, was his word. And the word was God himself, fully expressive of God. That's what that means. Not another person. So I like the Williams translation there. The word was God himself, not somebody else. You are what you think. As a man thinks, so is he. You are what you say. Out of the abundance of the heart, the man speaks. In Job 26, you'll find a wonderful verse there. What spirit is speaking through you? Whose words are these I'm hearing, Job says in 26 of Job? Whose spirit? Whose words? So words and spirit go together. And that marvelous self-expression of God, his logos, then became embodied in a real human being who began in the womb of his mother. Precisely because of the miracle worked in Mary, that's where Jesus began, Luke 1:32. Precisely because of the miracle, he'll be Son of God. No other reason, no pre-existing son. Even F.F. Bruce, you know, and other leading scholars admitted me somewhat privately, perhaps, they didn't think Paul believed in a pre-existing son. Some of them thought that John taught that, but they were not at all sure that Paul believed in pre-existing, whatever that means. How do you pre-exist yourself? How can you be before you are? You, Father, are the only one, or monos alithinos theos, the only one who is genuinely God. Your child of two understands that. So don't fish around for other verses where you think that Jesus is God. That would make two. Two is not one. It's not that hard. Simplicity, fishermen and farmers were the audience and students of Jesus. He didn't make it that hard. You, Father, are the only one who is true God. Nobody else can be. That should be utterly clear. Embrace it, enjoy it, make you feel better, and make you live longer.